I've hunted every Night Fury.
Except yours.
Hand him over.
I will never give him up.
Then I will destroy everything you love.
We are no longer safe here. We all have to disappear, completely off the map. We have to fight for their freedom.
What is up, guys? Kid Critic is back with another review, and this review is on the new film, How to Train Your Dragon, The Hidden World, which is directed by Dean DeBlois and stars Jay Baruchel, and it's about...
Now chief and ruler of Berk, alongside Astrid, Hiccup has created a gloriously chaotic dragon utopia when the sudden appearance of female Light Fury coincides with the darkest threat their village has ever faced. Hiccup and Toothless must leave the only home they've known and journey to a hidden world thought only to exist in myth. As their true destinies are revealed, Dragon and Rider will fight together to the very ends of the earth to protect everything they've grown to treasure.
So I really enjoy the How to Train Your Dragon series. I'm a bigger fan of the first one than the second one, and I know I'm probably in the minority because I know most people that I know like the second one more than the first one. So going into this movie, I was really looking forward to it, especially with all the rave reviews about it. And coming out of the movie, I loved this movie. Now, like, where does it rank among the three? I would say, like, this one and the first one go toe-to-toe. And I definitely enjoyed this one more than the second one. I did enjoy the second one, just so you know. And so I put, like, the third one with the first one. And one of the things I absolutely loved about this movie was the way they handled Hiccup's character. Because you definitely see his character evolve throughout the three films. And it kind of reminded me of Caesar in the Planet of the Apes trilogy or Luke Skywalker in the original Star Wars trilogy. The way they start off very young and ambitious. And then the second one, they just get closer to their goal. And then the third one, they finally get to their goal. Making peace with the galaxy or making peace between the apes and humans in Caesar's case. And then Hiccup's case, it'd be bringing peace with dragons. And I thought the way they handled this character in this film was fantastic. His Hiccup's relationship with Toothless, I think, is the best it's ever been. Their back and forth is great. They have some fabulous emotional moments, especially in the last 15 minutes. I mean, it probably make everyone cry. It's terrific what they did with both of those characters. I also like how Toothless kind of represents Hiccup in a way, and like where they are in their story, and they've kind of done that throughout all three movies, and they definitely do that in this film, and I really enjoyed that part of the movie. I also loved how they built upon the relationship between Hiccup and Astrid, and they definitely had some great moments together. This movie also had some great laughs, especially when it came to Toothless trying to get his girlfriend, and I thought that was really funny. And the animation in this series just gets better and better, and the animation in this film is superb. It just looks so beautiful. I'm a person who likes a lot of colors, and this movie definitely has lots of colors in it, and it looked amazing. This film also has some good action sequences that were really intense as well. Now, when it came to the villain, I thought the villain was probably the best out of the three movies, but that's not saying much. I mean, I wasn't a big fan of this villain. I thought, even though he was like a good strategist in the movie, other than that, there's like nothing else to him. And I do think there's some like generic lines and generic story elements. I could kind of tell what was going to happen. But other than that, I love this movie. What they did with Hiccup was great. The relationship between Hiccup and Toothless is phenomenal. The animation is great. And the way they ended this movie was just gave a perfect bow on this trilogy. But that said, guys, I definitely recommend How to Train Your Dragon, The Hidden World. And tell me down in the comment section below, have you seen How to Train Your Dragon 3? And what did you think about it? That's it, guys. Look out for the next video or review, and peace.